And here is the tale of the tape for this middleweight title tilt.
For these numbers are very, very similar. What you can't see in any of these numbers, though, is Peter Quillin's power. And that is the big question in this fight. If Rosado can deal with that, we will have a barn burner on our hands.
Gentlemen, this is for the WBO Middleweight Championship. Obey my commands at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. Touch them up. Let's go.
So we are set for the WBO Middleweight Championship bout as Peter Kid Chocolate Quillin gets set to make the second defense of the title. He won in October of 2012 in his new hometown of Brooklyn, New York. Rosado getting his second crack at a 160-pound championship. The bell and round one. The champion Quillin in the black and gold tiger stripes. Rosado in the white with gold. Rosado's family selling nearly $20,000 worth of tickets as they made the short trip to Atlantic City from Philadelphia. Everyone active on social media, including former welterweight champion Andre Berto, who is looking forward to a spirited scrap.
There you go.
And a big name in the Philadelphia area, of course, the undefeated 140-pound champion as Rosado gets tagged with a left hook, Danny Swift Garcia. Looking forward to the fight.
Well, the power of Quillin comes often in that left hook, and that's the one punch Rosado doesn't want to get hit with. He absorbed that one fairly well.
And Danny Garcia coming off a terrific victory over the hard-hitting Lucas Matisse. He will be guest tweeting all night and is going to be a guest later on this evening as our own Barry Tompkins will get a chance to talk to the champion as Rosado comes back with a right hand and tags Quillin with that overhand right.
Both guys have that look of focus in their eyes, but they're pouncing when they have a chance.
18 of Quillin's 20 knockouts have occurred inside 5 rounds, including 9 in the opening stanza. Meanwhile, Rosado has collected 2 victories inside the first round.
Peter Quillin has some defensive liabilities, and Fernando Guerrero and Hassan Endom, both of whom lost him, were able to hit him, but they were not able to absorb the power of Quillin. So we'll see how that goes with Rosado tonight.
Guerrero, their one common opponent. Quillin defeating him via 7th-round TKO in his first title defense back in April. Rosado lost to Guerrero on a night he said he had the flu. Of course, Rosado coming off a fight with Jay Leon Love earlier this year. Originally a disputed split decision win for Love that was overturned and ruled a no contest after Love tested positive for banned diuretics. Under 30 seconds now remaining in the opening round. Left hook by Quillin.
Rosado giving a lot of head movement to Chocolate, Kid Chocolate. He's trying to work his way in without getting too reckless. But he's not sticking the jab the way maybe could get Kid Chocolate's attention. Let's see maybe if he's just trying to set a trap by pawing with it.
So two athletes who have been in the same gym involved in a bit of a getting to know you round, although they end with a flurry of punches as round one is in the books.
Round one, Peter Quillin was able to land his signature punch, which is the left hook. He fainted and then he knocked that left hook off the temple of Rosado. Not a perfect punch, but it did land. What do these fighters, in fact, have to do? For Peter Quillin, I think he's got to think defense. Sometimes he forgets about defense. It could be a problem in this fight. Create a firefight. Make Gabe Rosado, who's coming up in weight from 154, make him be in a firefight. And the left hook, which we saw, he was able to get in the first round. As for Gabe Rosado, smart pressure is what he wants, and that's kind of what he did in the first round. He did not throw any combinations. That is vital. You are not going to beat Peter Quillin throwing one punch at a time. And I believe he's got to stay out of the trenches. He can work close sometimes, but not stand in a wheelhouse.
So we are set for round number 2, scheduled for 12 rounds for the WBO Middleweight Championship. Rosado trained by Billy Briscoe, the champion Quillin trained by Eric Brown. Paulie, he's your trainer. What's his standout attribute as a trainer?
He's a thinking trainer. You know, he likes his fighters to be cerebral in there, and you guys will work on things in the gym, but at the same time, he emphasizes thinking on your own once you're in the ring, and seeing things on your own and using your eyes basically, adjusting on the fly, so to speak.
And Eric, of course, working closely with Freddie Roach. The Wildcard West Gym, the proprietors of that, Gary Shandling, great comedian, Peter Berg, film director.
And you see Rosado kind of pawing with the left hand. Seems like he's trying to set a trap. We're trying to lure Quillin in so that he can counter him.
Lead right hand to the body by Quillin. Of course, the sweet science all about timing and distance, and at the highest level, it is about setting those traps, right, Paulie?
Yeah, exactly.
I think it's a testimony to the ability of both men that this is a tactical fight to this point. Neither, and both are aggressive fighters, neither feels comfortable attacking wildly in this fight.
Which, going in, they were both known for their power shots. The majority of their punches have been.
But watch Quillin. Quillin is also pulling with the jab, but at times he sticks it in there, so he's varying the attack. And that's what Rosado has to do. He has to vary it a little better. A lot of he's only pulling there. He stuck out the jab there. He's got to mix it so that Quillin cannot time Rosado's entrance into the wheelhouse, so to speak.
Gabe Rosado said he wanted to be busy in this fight and use a fair amount of volume of punches. Hasn't done that yet.
Still in the early stages, less than a minute. Yes, right, left in the second round. As Quillin, the champion, walking down Rosado along the ropes. Very much the chess match. Lead right hand and a left hook, and Rosado's head glove touched the canvas. Down in his career.
A bit of a balance shot, but part of it was due to the fact that Rosado puts himself out of position when he makes a defensive move. He's got to keep those moves a little shorter. It's a good body shot by Quillin.
Left hook to the body by the champion. With 15 seconds left in the second round. A round that's been punctuated by the knockdown. So as we head to round three, the champion is in control.
You gotta back this guy up. You gotta back him up behind the double jab. Up and down with that jab.
Back him up now.
Yes, sir. You gotta back him up. Back him up smart. He's looking for big shots. He's gonna come out hard this round.
Okay.
It's the advice from Billy Briscoe, backing him up with the jab. In this case, it was Rosado backing himself into the corner and a nice short left hook. Peter Quillin's punch of choice is that hook. He set it up very nicely, throwing the right hand and then coming with that left hook behind it, just behind the guard of Gabe Rosado. And Peter Quillin's wife, Allie, quite happy about this turn of events. Former middleweight contender and now middleweight contender Danny Jacobs, a fellow New Yorker to Kid Chocolate.
Yeah, there's talk that he may, in fact, get a shot at that middleweight crown in the near future.
Now, I actually saw Danny in the gym earlier this week, and he actually said, he was very interested in the winner of
right.
this fight.
And what better place than Brooklyn, right, Paulie, with both of them putting down their roots there.
Absolutely. If Peter can come out of this out with this with a win, it would
right.
be a big
win. Don't want to overlook Rosado's chances whatsoever, as we are still very early here in this WBO middleweight championship affair. Nice right hand by Rosado. Left hook behind the guard by Quillin. Thus far, Rosado unable to heed the advice of his trainer, Billy Briscoe, Al, who, as you mentioned, wanted him to back Quillin up with the double jab.
Well, and it's part of throwing more than one punch at a time for Gabe Rosado, and he hasn't been doing that. The power punch edge for Quillin, and most important, two of those 12 were strong enough to really have an impact on Gabe Rosado.
In the clinch, they throw punches, and the referee calls for the break.
So Rosado's trainer, Billy Briscoe, asked him to back Quillin up this round. And Rosado said, okay, I'm going to back him up this round. And so far, he's got Quillin backing up a little bit. Now he's got to start landing some shots and go get Quillin's respect.
Just past the midpoint of round three.
Rosado is a real warrior. He turned on a fight with contender Matthew Macklin, also a lucrative fight, to fight Quillin for a title. And that tells you all you need to know about Rosado.
And I think partly was the fact that he wanted to be on the same card as his mentor, Bernard Hopkins, someone he's been around since Hopkins was preparing to fight Joe Calzaghe. There's the jab by Rosado, under a minute remaining in the round.
A bit more of an aggression out of Rosado this time around, this round.
He's getting busier, and he has to be if he's going to win this fight.
Absolutely. Quillin remaining balanced, remaining composed. Rosado still having to work his way in, but at least it seems like he's giving it more of an effort now. Seems like he needed to warm up those first couple of rounds. I'll tell you, he's got Quillin backing up, but Quillin a lot of times is hesitant on pulling the trigger on those counter shots. He's backed himself to the ropes without punching.
We saw Hassan Endom do this.
Quillin lands a very effective jab with less than 15 seconds now remaining into the third frame, and there's a left hand by Quillin.
And that's what you were talking about, Al, that left hook by Quillin.
Step back, no punches, 5 seconds.
A lot of times he'll establish it with the jab and mask it, and then he'll let whip a left hook in there.
So we are through three rounds here at Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City as we are joined by our Spanish commentators, former champion El Diamante Raul Marquez and the silky smooth Alejandro Luna. Showtime Championship Boxing, of course, available in Spanish at SAP.
Petey, don't wait so much, all right? Keep touching with that jab and faking him, okay? Every now and again, he's getting used to seeing you working off that left hand now. Set him up for that right hand leading left hook, okay? But make sure you keep your hands up. When you get done going, I want that left hand back up. He's trying to count it.
This is your night. This is your night, brother. You go in there, you enhance your defense, you walk him down. You punch him between his shots.
The bell and the beginning of a round four. WBO middleweight champion Peter Quillin undefeated at 29-0 with 21 wins via form of a knockout. The challenger, 27-year-old Gabriel Rosado, comes in with a record of 21-6 with one no contest, 13 wins inside the distance. He has been stopped twice in his career. Quillin has yet to be dropped in his career.
This is a fight coming that could have been a trap fight for Quillin. Nice left hook by him as he continues the pressure because he's waiting for a big fight against some other middleweight that is another champion or whatever. And this could have been a trap fight. He's approaching it very well, though.
Says that he is the second best middleweight after Sergio Martinez. A rather humble statement as we look at the unofficial scoring from our Showtime crew.
We all have got it essentially the same. We do have it the same, in fact. Of course, it was a 10-8 round mixed in there, and we've got all the rounds for Peter Quillin at this juncture. And, Paulie, I can't see a round that Rosado won.
No, I thought Rosado got a bit more aggressive in the last round. I want to see if he can keep that momentum going, but I didn't think it was enough to give him the round, but he showed some positive signs in that he got a bit more aggressive, and I want to see if he can continue that into this round. So far, he hasn't, though.
That 1-2 combination blocked by Rosado.
Step back, no punches.
Just past the midway point of the fourth frame.
So I like the balance of Quillin. Doesn't really get himself out of position at all, either offensively or defensively. Good left hook there. And again, it was the reason for that landing was his proper balance on the inside as well.
Let me go.
Come
So watch, even as he backs up, he maintains that center of gravity very well. Rosado doing a lot of head movement, trying to get Quillin confused or out of position, looking for him to bite on something.
Yes, yet he bites down on a jab.
Yeah, well, you know, at least he's giving it an effort. You know, he's trying to get Quillin out of that shell because Quillin has the firepower. He can kind of walk Rosado into those big power shots if he doesn't lean into any of Rosado's traps.
Step back.
30 seconds left in the round.
Step back. Let it go, let it go, let it go.
Oh, there's a right hand by Rosado that connects.
And again, it's due to the fact that Rosado got aggressive. He stepped in. A lot of times he's kind of pawing and waiting for Quillin to step in. He's got to take the initiative.
There's another lead right hand by Rosado as he closes the fourth round strong with Quillin on the ropes momentarily.
And that's what Rosado needed to do.
This fight, using the right hand to set up the left hook. He's done it about four or five times. There it is, and he always follows with the hook. That one was a little cuffing, but it got in. However, the main story in this round was in the last 30 seconds when Rosado, who has been throwing that right hand but not landing it perfectly, got a beauty in. That was a very straight punch. It wobbled Quillin, and then Rosado kept at it to try and get to him. And it was a very good effort by him. And then the left uppercut punctuated things at the end of the round.
Quillin got caught with that right hand because was trying to throw a right-hand uppercut from the outside, and he walked into the big right hand by Rosado. I was just talking about Quillin's patience and his balance, and he kind of got away from it in that moment, and that's why you need to stay patient and balanced, because at any point in a world-class fight, you can be caught and hurt. He threw a right-hand uppercut from a place where he shouldn't have been.
Round five begins as Rosado, with a lot of fans in attendance, they're exhorting their fighter from Philly after a strong finish to the fourth frame, and there's another good right hand by the challenger, Rosado.
Tell you what, speaking of right hand, it seems like Rosado's found a home for that right hand in the past round and a half or so.
Although Quillin comes back again with his trademark right hand followed by the left hook, and now Rosado putting his left hand behind his back. A bit of gamesmanship here.
The power punches have closed dramatically. In fact, they're even because Rosado is landing punches. Rosado wants now to get Quillin off his game. I think that's part of the showboating, but he better pay attention to what he's doing.
Well, both guys feeling confident right now. They both landed some pretty good shots early in this round.
Rosado's histrionics bringing a positive reaction from the crowd, but as you mentioned, has to be very wary against the undefeated champion, Kid Chocolate, Peter Quillin, with a minute 45 left in the fifth round. Quillin with the lead left, sticks it.
Rosado trained with bigger fighters at 170, even 180 pounds, to simulate the power of Quillin so he could get through it. And he has, other than the knockdown, gotten through the power so far of Quillin.
Yeah, he says that he's becoming more comfortable, that he's grown into a middleweight frame, and the only way he would go back down to junior middleweight would be for a very big fight. He feels that 160 pounds is where he belongs now.
And he's filling into the weight well.
Misses with that right cross.
But he's getting more confident in throwing it. Even if he doesn't land it fully all the time, Rosado's getting confident in letting go of the power, something we weren't seeing early.
Final 60 seconds of the fifth round. The challenger, Rosado, beginning to come on here.
And when Rosado faints, he's getting Quillin in a position where he might land that right hand. More feints from him will really get the job done for Rosado.
And for the first time in this fight, the champion Quillin circling, moving backward a little bit. Earlier, he had been pressing the action. Seems to have a little more respect for Rosado's power now out. Lands a jab.
The thing Rosado might want to do is take a bit of a harder step to the right side, to his right, to Quillin's left. He's allowing Quillin to turn the corner. He could be cutting him off and putting even more mental pressure on Quillin. Instead, he's allowing Quillin to kind of turn and circle the ring a little bit. And that's a little bit dangerous because Quillin can walk him into a check left hook.
Final 10 seconds. of this WBO middleweight championship scrap. Things beginning to heat up here between the challenger Rosado and the champion Kid Chocolate.
Hey, Gabriel.
You're reaching because you're not stepping with the jab. Step with both jabs. Pop, pop. Step with both jabs and let your hands go. You hear me? You got this, buddy. You got this. You step with both hands, walk this guy down, and let your hands go. Don't worry about loading up.
The right hand has become the punch of choice for Rosado. Sets it up with a pawing jab and dicks the chin of Quillin. Quillin trying to counter right away, but that right hand getting in for Rosado. And Gabe Rosado showing a little bravado as he showboats a bit. But I think a lot of that's designed to show Peter Quillin that I'm here and now I feel I'm back in this fight. And he probably is.
Round six. Scheduled for 12 for the WBO Middleweight Championship. The champion, Peter Quillin, putting the belt on the line for the second time against challenger Gabriel Rosado, who is challenging for a 160-pound title for the second time this year. Rosado came to the sport of boxing at a relatively late age, started at 18, but he was raised in North Philadelphia, very tough part of the city and a part of the town that spawned greats like Smokin' Joe Frazier and Benny Briscoe and Georgie Benton. The list goes on and on, Al.
It is an amazing tradition. And Rosado showing the courage to step up to fight Gennady Golovkin at 160 pounds in his very first 160-pound fight. And that demonstrates what he's all about, and that's what Philly fighters are all about.
Of course, another Philly fighter coming up in our next bout, the main event, as Bernard Hopkins will defend his light heavyweight title as Quillin ate another right hand from Rosado. You sense the tide is beginning to turn, Paulie.
Well, Rosado's getting more and more confident walking Quillin down. Less output from Peter Quillin as he backs up. Earlier in the fight, even if he was backing up, there was more offense coming. Now Quillin is backing up and is a little bit more reluctant to throw those punches. He's got to get that confidence back, or Rosado is starting to take it from him. Right now, it's mental pressure. And that's what I mean here, where he allows Quillin to turn the corner and lets Quillin land a check left hook. If Rosado's going to walk him down, he'd be better set to cut him off and step over hard to his right.
That left hand connects. Another left up jab connects by Rosado, but he gets hit with a couple of jabs from Quillin. Under a minute left here in the sixth.
Peter Quillin has never been the most efficient fighter on the inside.
Left hook connects.
Yeah, he is efficient at. And so when Rosado's on the inside, he's faring pretty well.
From Quillin, final 30 seconds of the sixth round.
It's a pretty close round and could be a pivotal one in score.
Oh, lead right hand that. By Quillin, followed by that left hook behind the guard. Double jab from Rosado. And again, putting on the pressure is Gabriel Rosado with the champion along the ropes, clinching. Referee calls for the break as we head into the second half of this championship.
Rosado is able to get on the inside against Quillin. He's pretty effective, mixing up his punches, using uppercuts like that one, occasionally going to the body. Not everything's landing, but he's getting some work done on the inside there. Now, that was a very, very close round. Quillin doing some good counter-punching in that round, and Rosado attacking.
You're catching with good combinations, but I need you to start turning it up a little bit more. All right? Short, quick shots. Yep. And work on the inside. All right? Let's go. good. That's good. Let's go. I got it. Go.
Yeah, Eric Brown telling Peter Quillin, work on the inside when you get in there. A lot of times he's allowing Rosado to out-hustle him a little bit.
Round seven begins the second half of this championship bout, both with limited amateur experience. And Al, when you take a look at their records after six, we have Quillin, who is 8-0 with two wins inside the distance, while Rosado is 9-3, four stoppage wins in the one no contest.
Well, both men are accustomed to going a ways in fights, and as you can see, they do well. So I think conditioning is going to be a big issue as we go out down the road, and also who can get some body shots in.
Well, so far, Rosado targeting the champion's head along the ropes.
Punch away out,
and
punch
now
away out.
Quillin connects as he heeds the advice of the referee to punch out. Here are the unofficial Showtime scores at the midway point.
We are all in the same ballpark, and Steve, you have a one-point edge, as Paulie does for Peter Quillin.
Well, it's certainly getting tighter. I thought early on Quillin was much more effective, but in that third round, Rosado turned up the heat, and the little body punching that's been done in this fight has been done by Rosado.
Yep.
So all the momentum right now is Rosado, although it's a very close fight.
And he landed two right uppercuts in close in that exchange.
And the only reason my score was a little different was I had the last round even, and you guys gave it to Rosado, and you can easily make a case for that.
I just felt like he out-hustled Quillin a little bit late at the end of the round. He showed he wanted the round just a little more because it was a very, very tough round to score.
I'm just more indecisive, that's all.
But Rosado again coming forward. Quillin, uppercut.
And Rosado walks into the right uppercut, and there's a right cross. A right hand misses. Now Rosado on the ropes, but doing a good job of circling away.
That's Quillin's best punch in a couple of rounds. Rosado's undaunted, coming forward still.
Lead right uppercut by the champion, Quillin.
You know, it landed, but it led before an uppercut from way behind by him getting hit by a big punch by Rosado, which Paulie pointed out. So Quillin has to be careful about throwing that punch from so far out.
Under a minute left in the seventh round.
I think a lot of times when you start throwing these weird punches from the outside, you're looking for something to stop the guy from pressuring you. You know, it could be, I'm not saying Quillin is frustrated. You see a good exchange here. And this is where Eric Brown told Peter Quillin to move your hands on the inside.
Best exchange of the fight.
Because Rosado's been out hustling Quillin on the inside, but now Quillin punching back and backing Rosado off. And this is what he needs to do. Earlier on, he was kind of just laying in there. Oh, good shot by Rosado.
And now we have the makings of the firefight we expected as they are trading punches here with less than 20 seconds left in the seventh round. Left hook to the body blocked. So a spirited seventh round comes to an end here at Boardwalk Hall, Atlantic City.
Rosado, using his jab to work his way in, was able to land some good shots, including the left uppercut that has been a staple of the Rosado attack in the last couple of rounds. And then they have an excellent exchange where Quillin returns the favor with his right uppercut. And, of course, remember, that punch hurt Rosado earlier in the round.
Get your shots off and get back in the middle of that ring. You understand me? No camping on the rope. You got to outbox this guy. All right, we got our boxing the rest of the way, okay? So stay loose. Stay loose. Don't show him nothing.
We are set for the eighth round. The WBO middleweight championship up for grabs. The champion, Peter Quillin, in the black and gold tiger stripes. The challenger, King Gabriel Rosado, in the white with gold trunks.
This last round was interesting because both men, according to show stats, had their highest percentage landed, or had its number landed. Rosado landed 13 punches, Quillin landed 11. It's the highest they've landed per round in this fight so far, and that was an excellent round.
Paulie, expound a little bit on what Eric Brown told Quillin, the champion, in the between rounds.
Well, he told him to stay off the ropes, keep the fight in the middle of the ring, and outbox him in the middle of the ring. I want to see if Quillin, as he backs himself up to the ropes here, I want to see if he makes an effort to stay on the ropes a little less, because a lot lot of times, even if it's not happening, it can seem like you're being out-hustled if you're back into the ropes the whole round. So far, he got backed up once, and he got himself right off. Let's see here what he does. He can get himself off the ropes.
We said what would happen if Rosado could deal with the power of Quillin. He has mostly done that so far. Remember, there was a 10-8 round early because of a knockdown by Quillin.
Right hand to the body by Rosado and the jab. And again, Quillin along the ropes as Rosado begins to pour on the pressure.
Yeah, and Rosado keeps walking Quillin down. It's funny, he got dropped in the second round. Then Billy Briscoe in the corner told him, you got to start walking him down. Walk your man down. And Rosado has not stopped walking Peter Quillin down ever since he received those instructions.
And Rosado attacking the body.
Pick it up, Pete.
And the champion Quillin responds in kind, but he finds himself hemmed in the corner again. And Rosado, even though a lot of those punches are being blocked, putting on the pressure. Minute left in the eighth round. Very close, very competitive championship affair. And now Quillin coming back with a right. There's a left uppercut by Rosado. The jab by Rosado. Quillin again with the left hook behind the guard.
Peter Quillin is landing some very good punches this round, but by backing himself against the rope and letting the volume of punches of Rosado hit him, he could be losing the round.
Rosado demonstrating that that left hook did not hurt him, and he loads up with that right hand. 30 seconds left in the eighth.
And it's mental pressure. When Quillin lands his best shots and Rosado continues to walk him down, it mentally can make a fighter second-guess himself. Quillin is used to having guys stop in their tracks when he hits them.
Stiff jab by Quillin connects. There's a right hand over the top by Rosado. 10 seconds left in an entertaining eighth round. So we are through eight rounds of this championship belt. The main event will also be a championship affair. Let's go to Jim Gray standing by with B-Hawk.
All right, thank you very much, Mo. You have said earlier this evening that you feel as though this fight with Murat is a speed bump. But at your age, can you afford to really look past a bump in the road? Can you really afford to look past anybody and have a bump in the road?
Never, never, never could look past anybody. Can't afford it. Too expensive.
You sitting in here watching this fight, we were just talking about it. You don't know whether you're going out in 5 minutes or an hour in 5 minutes, and you're watching this. What goes through you?
The anticipation of, you know, what I'm gonna do, and also what I'm watching, because I know both guys, and you know, I love both guys, and you know, just make the time go by a little quicker. But I'm ready to go out there.
All right, we know you are. Who's winning this fight in your estimation?
I think it's even as close these last couple of rounds. I believe it's ninth round now, but it's going to be real close. But they got to pull this round out, whoever's going to win.
B-Hop, we'll talk to you afterwards.
Thank you.
All right, back out to you, Mo.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. Bernard Hopkins getting set to make history again as the oldest man ever to defend a boxing title in the main event. But we are in the midst of this middleweight championship affair. Round nine begins. And in his last two fights, Gabriel Rosado against Golovkin and Love, they were able to really kind of hold down his high-volume attack, and yet, Paulie, as this fight unfolds, he's beginning to increase his volume.
Well, it seems like he's grown into the middleweight division with each fight. You know, he started out in the Golovkin fight coming up from junior middleweight, and he decided to stay at middleweight, fighting the Jay Leon Love fight. He looked a little stronger, a little better in that fight. Obviously, Love is not Golovkin, but still a solid fighter. And now this fight here, you know, Quillin, a known puncher at middleweight. Rosado was knocked down in round two. Credit to him. Kudos to him. A good shot by Quillin. Kudos to Rosado for having the resilience to come back and actually walk his man down after being knocked down.
Totals in this fight, and you can see how close it is. And one of the key things is a lot of the Quillin small edge was built up in the early rounds. So it's all divided by what punches were landed in each round as to how a man is doing in this fight.
Peter Quillin, the lone American with a claim to the middleweight championship. Good lead left hook behind the guard there by the champion. Sergio Martinez from Argentina, Darren Barker from England, and Gennady Golovkin from Kazakhstan also with claims to the middleweight throne. But Rosado, he would like to live up to his nickname of King here tonight in front of family and friends as, again, they come close. Just past the midway point of the ninth round.
For the most part, Peter Quillin has gone backwards in the last several rounds. But that isn't to say that he hasn't landed effective punches, and that's especially true in this round. That's what makes these rounds fairly close.
That mental pressure. Quillin, a good poker face, but his output has dropped. Not as much snap on his shots. Rosado,
right hand there by Rosado. Final 60 seconds.
Rosado looking more confident, and Quillin needs to pick himself up a little bit. Mentally, he's got to push himself here these final rounds if he wants to hold on to the title.
There's the 1-2 by Rosado, and again lets out a woo! 45 seconds left as Quillin wants to smother Rosado's offensive attack.
Rosado has created the impression and the perception, and some of it is true, that he's the stalker. And even when Quillin lands a good counterpunch, Rosado is taking the play away from him right now.
Under 30 seconds left in the ninth. Left hook to the body. There's a nice stiff jab by Quillin as again they clinch. And referee Huggins intercedes. Oh, a stiff jab by the champion Quillin.
And a cut.
Yes, a bad cut around the left eye of Rosado.
That's a bad cut, man.
What a shame during a fight like this.
And remember, it was cuts
five
that
seconds.
Cost
five
him the fight against Golovkin, although he was being battered throughout, although proved to be a very courageous warrior as we are about to head to round 10. And Peter Quillin's family now looking on with some concern.
You got this. Listen to me. Tilt back.
Right on the island.
Close out. Tilt back. You got this, brother.
In my eyes, huh?
Gabe Rosado early in the round landing that right hand as he has so many in recent rounds. And then a very difficult situation for Rosado. A jab that from Quillin that appears to have opened up the cut. Right after this, the blood would spurt. And Rosado has a terrible cut over that left eye. So sometimes Gabe Rosado has had some tough luck. He's got it again here.
Yes, he was cut against Golovkin over the left eye in the second round. And cut against Sal Roman over the left eye as well. But that was the result of a head clash. So the referee and the doctor allow the fight to continue as we begin round 10.
You hope both guys can get through these three rounds, man. You know, Rosado's put up such a good effort. He deserves to be able to finish this fight. As it's very competitive. I mean, this fight is still up for grabs. Let's see if the cut also spurns Quillin to increase his output.
Jim Gray has a report from the doctor at ringside. Let's go to Jim.
Mo, I just spoke to Dr. Jordan Garrison. He said that the cut over the left eye is okay for now. He emphasized for now, and now the doctor is coming back over to take a look at it as he's being summoned by Alan Huggins.
Doesn't look good anymore.
I can see, man.
The blood and guts warrior Gabriel Rosado for the second time in a championship fight. It is the plasma that will cost him a chance to become champion. As we look at the final show stats, the fight officially over at 40 seconds of round 10, Al.
Well, these numbers indicate how close the fight was. The last few rounds of the fight had probably been controlled by Rosado to a great extent. And these numbers very close, and it demonstrates what a good fight this was. And tough break.
So a tough way to end this championship bout. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr. to make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 40 seconds in round number 10. A referee in charge, Alan Huggins, stops the contest upon advice of a ringside physician. He is the winner by way of technical knockout. He is still undefeated. He is still the WBO middleweight champion of the world, Peter Kid Chocolate Quillin.
Showtime Championship Boxing starts 2014 with an all-action doubleheader. Lamont Peterson climbed from the streets of Washington, D.C. to the top of the junior welterweight division by facing the toughest opposition. Now the King of the Hill faces Quebec's biggest secret, undefeated number one contender Thierry Jean. Plus, heavy-handed 22-0 Jermell Charlo steps up to his toughest challenge, Philly tough Gabriel Rosado. Don't miss the showdown, Saturday, January 25th at 9, 8 Central, only on Showtime.